Hello students, so now in this segment of the video, as you can see on the board, I'm going to start with the organic chemistry part, and I've decided to start with the electronic effect first, so that when we have the grip of that, the senior inter part also becomes easy, as well as the junior inter part. It is the junior inter part in itself. So now I'm going to start with the inductive effect, quickly going to the mesomeric and then hyperconjugation. Again, it's a revision video, so make sure that first and foremost thing is to be very well versed in your notes. In case you are seeing this video after seeing some other video, it's better you go through your notes first, start doing some questions, because seeing 3-4 videos will not make you better in a concept. So keep this in mind, videos are a very good tool, but they cannot replace the notes that you are having in your hands, which you are having in your bags. So make sure completely focus upon the notes, read the theory very well. This will just help you to give a quick revision of the thing. In simple words, I am just a catalyst who will make your reading faster. But make sure reading you have to do. Just seeing the video like a movie is not going to help. Understand now. So what is inductive effect? So firstly, we have to understand all the inductive effect is plus I minus I both are sigma effect. What does it mean? There is a sigma bond and there is a pi bond. When the sigma electron shifts toward one of the atom, that is called sigma effect. When the pi electron shifts, it is called pi effect. So let's go one by one. So what is minus I? Minus I means if I am a minus I group, what does it mean? That means I am more electronegative. So imagine we two are bonded to each other and I am more electronegative. I have given one electron of mine, you have given one electron of yours, and we made a bond. So basically, A and B have given one more electron and you made a bond here. Now this electron density should ideally be in the middle of the two, because you both are equally contributing for making the bond. But let us say the electronegativity of B is more than electronegativity of A, so this electronegative person will attract the shared pair of electrons towards itself. So what will happen? Effectively, this electron cloud will be partially shifted towards B. So B get a slight negative charge. And A will lose the electron, he gets a slight positive charge. That slight negative, slight positive is also known as partial negative and partial positive charge, which is less than the charge on one electron. So it's a partial shifting, so partial charge. Now, what is minus I? Minus I is the attraction of the sigma bonded electron towards more electronegative atom. How to remember the order? Simple here. If I am positively charged, obviously I will attract the shared pair of electron towards myself. Positive attracts the electron, obviously, here, because positive attracts negative. So A plus, like Nr2 plus, Sr2 plus, all these examples. Oh, sorry, Nr3 plus, Sr2 plus, all these examples are there of A plus. A plus will have more minus I effect. Then NO2, Cl, SO3H, this segment you can remember together. Then carbonyl and COOH and the derivative you can remember together. Then all the halogens. Within halogen you can easily find, like fluorine is more than chlorine, is more than bromine, is more than iodine. Just remember this thing. Minus I is nothing but electronegativity only. More electronegative atom, more minus I, more or less. So here, halogen, after halogen, OH. After OH, NH2. Why NH2 after OH comes? Simple, yeah, because nitrogen is less electronegative, oxygen is more electronegative. So oxygen will have a more tendency to attract the shared pair of electron towards itself. Which shared pair? Sigma or pi? Answer should be sigma, because we are talking about inductive effect. Now what does it mean? This is the first order we have to keep in mind. In case you don't want to remember the whole order given in your notes, at least this much you should remember. That's the simplest thing. Now the next trick you have to remember is that if the atom is same, that means nitrogen, 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 oxygen, oxygen, atom is same, and the substituents increases, alkyl group increases. So more the alkyl group on the nitrogen or on the oxygen, more electronegativity will be there, or more minus I will be there. That means Nr2 2R will have more minus I than NHR will have more minus I than NH2. This came in the NEET 2018 also. If this logic you remember, it will be easier for you to decide in the exam as well. And OR is more than OH. I think it is fair enough. So Nr2 more than NHR more than NH2. Why? More the alkyl group, more will be the electronegativity, more will be the minus I. Now, if the doubt comes up why Nr2 is having more minus I, then in the revision it is not much important. But something, if you are strong in chemical bonding, I can explain in very simple words. If you are good in chemical bonding only, then only you will understand that. So understand, Nr2, R group comes. So bond angle increases. Higher bond angle means more percent S character. SP hybridization has the bond angle of 180 degree. SP2 120 degree, SP3 109.5 degree. So as you can see, the bond angle is increasing, S character is also increasing. And more S character is more electronegative. So here, as the R group becomes, NH2 becomes Nr2, that means R group comes, angle increases. As a result, percent S character increases. As a result, electronegativity and minus I increases. This explanation is only for those people who are aiming for top 100. Otherwise, it does not matter what the logic is. You have to just remember this answer as Nr2 more than NHR more than NH2. Let's see some examples. Chlorine is more electronegative here. So chlorine, bhai saab, attract the shared pair of electron towards himself, getting a delta minus. CH3, poor fellow, lost the electron, gets a delta plus. Similarly, chlorine here attract the shared pair of electrons from CH2, which in turn attract from the next one, which in turn attract from the next one. So we can understand, chlorine gets delta minus, the adjacent gets delta plus, let us say. Then the next carbon gets delta delta plus. That means lesser charge. This person has lesser charge than the previous one. Even further person has even lesser charge than the previous one. That means as you are going far away from the atom who was minus I, your effect of minus I is decreasing. So chlorine will have maximum effect on the adjacent carbon and minimum towards the second and third carbon. That means inductive effect is distance dependent. Further away the atom is there, less affected that atom will be from the minus I effect. Keep this in mind. Now second, plus I. What is plus I? Nothing here. Minus I was attraction of sigma bonded electron. Plus I is donation of sigma bonded electron. So here, let's say methyl is there. Methyl gives electron towards benzene. These three methyl happily are giving the electron towards this positive. Mostly, the plus I effect is shown by the alkyl group. Again, no need to go into the depth of it. There are few things you should just remember them. Just like in mathematics, even if you don't go into the depth of how a plus b whole square comes as a square plus b square plus 2ab, but you keep on using that. Nowadays YouTube has come, so you might have seen the videos also ki how they are dividing the square into different parts and getting the answer. But back in the time when you actually read a plus b whole square, you might be knowing it, you didn't know why, but you just remember the formula. So treat this order as just, and this order as just the formula for the organic chemistry. If the formula is strong, practice is good, even organic chemistry will start behaving like mathematics. So now let us see. Mostly alkyl group show plus I effect. Alkyl group have electron donating effect. You can see three alkyl groups here, so more electron donating. Two alkyl group here with CH, less electron donating. One alkyl group there with CH2, even less electron donating. Just one methyl group, least electron donating. I hope this part is clear. Double bonded, triple bonded carbon. Triple bonded carbon is sp. Double bonded carbon is sp2. And sp is more electronegative than sp2. They are minus I group. Single bonded carbon is the plus I group. That means sp3 hybrid carbon are plus I group. sp2 and sp hybrid carbons are minus I group. So this is about the electronic effect of inductive. Now, I am going to start with the hyperconjugation. Let us check.